It is religious persecution to use a word that we all know represents happy in order to describe a certain sexual orientation. It's not okay by any means. That's not the only problem. And this is worldwide. This isn't just here in America. This is worldwide that this persecution is going on. There are ways that we can come together in order to make peaceful change where this is concerned. The other issue is where the use of the rainbow symbol is concerned. This is also a direct persecution against the Bible and Christians. And it was purposely intended to be that by the person who made the rainbow the symbol. He said that was his purpose when he did it. And so he has passed away. And it's now a worldwide symbol of persecution against Christians. Considering the rainbow is a already spoken for symbol in accordance with the Word of God in the Bible, in reference to Genesis 9:11 through 13, it specifically claims the rainbow. And so I ask and urge all of you who are of that community and who do use that symbol to try to talk amongst yourselves, knowing that we are looking for peace here. And so in the effort to find peace, we respectably ask that the symbol be changed in order to stop persecution of Christians. Not just Christians, because there's other religions, major religions, such as the Muslims, the Catholics, the Buddhists, and many other religions that accept the rainbow as a symbol of God and the word in the Bible as word. So for those of you who are in acceptance of that, this is part of the reason that we're having problems with other countries, is because of the situation surrounding the LGBTQ and the rainbow and the word gay in reference to the dialect with regards to the Bible. On top of that, it's an insult to my tribe, which is from Native America. It's the original tribe of Thanksgiving, and it's originally called the tribe of Gay Head. So it specifically persecutes my people as the original people from this country, the Native Americans, who are indigenous, and it is documented are from the biblical tribe of Gad. I am a born doll. Numbers 1:14 in the Bible, it specifically lists the tribe of Gad as Dul. Anyway, my purpose here is this. It's time for real change. The only way we're going to get that is to work together to find peace. Just like I say with law enforcement with regards to Black Lives Matters and marijuana, there are bridges that we can use in order to create peace, not just here, but to show the effort with regards to around the world where peace is concerned. It's time to start working together instead of trying to tear each other down. The attitude has a lot to do with it, too. When you choose to be angry and nasty and mean, nobody gets any resolution. All you do is keep going around in circles over and over and over again, until you get tired and you find a new group to do that with. And so the cycle continues. We're trying to break that cycle. We want to break the chains, so to speak, and try to create real change that makes a real difference. And the only way we can do that is to come together and compromise. That's how that's done, with a good attitude, knowing that each side has to give something in order to find peaceful resolution with God's love. God bless America. Have a blessed day. And pack the badge.